curious volume, forgotten lore. Eagerly I wish tomorrow, but vainly it sought to borrow from my book's secrete of sorrow, sorrow for the lost Lenore. Though there was so much more to the story, more than anyone thought before, a story of love, betrayal, and the remnants of pain that I still bore. So be patient, my dear people, as today you will learn the truth on my dear lost love, Lenore. A beautiful young lady like you doing out here?
Oh, nothing. I hope I didn't give you any ideas.
Of course not. I'm merely curious. What is a beautiful girl like you doing out here at 9:45 with a book of lore?
You don't really care, do you?
Of course I do. Lore's my specialty. I'm a scholar in literature. So intriguing.
If it truly interests you, I've decided to run away.
Run away? From who?
From men like you.
Witness. I'm sorry for going off the wrong foot. It's just, it's been so long since I've seen such a girl of your demeanor. And that book, it's very close to my heart. I just got nervous, that's all.
Right. Sir, may I ask you your name?
Edgar. Edgar Poe.
And Edgar, do you wish to know my name?
Of course I do, but you haven't introduced yourself yet.
Good, let's keep it that way.
Madam, wait. I'm sorry you got the wrong message. I have an interest in you. That is true. But it was all because of that book. That's all, I swear.
Well, what can you tell me about the book?
Well, first, I mean, where do I start? There's 3 whole volumes written about the Old English. Of course I have. It's my passion.
Lenore?
And it was so good to see someone else.
Lenore? Oh, where did that girl go?
Goodness!
Lenore, is that your name?
Shh, Edgar, listen to me. You must go.
But who is that? Who's following you?
Please, Edgar, we'll meet again. I swear. Just go home.
Yourself killed.
I can take care of myself, William. I'm not made of glass.
Of course not. All glass has sharp edges. You're as fragile as a flower. Oh, you don't know how much I missed you. Where did your ring go?
I lost it.
You don't just lose a ring, Lenore. It was a family heirloom. I know you. You don't lose anything. Where do you put the ring? I knew it. Now you listen to me, Lenore. In 2 days' time, we'll be married. On our way to our honeymoon, hand in hand, happy, in love. Ah, love, I tell you. We have the chance to be the happiest couple alive.
Huh.
Try running away again, Lenore. Take 1 step outside the house, and I promise you, you will regret till death do us part. Do you understand? Good. Shall we go home now, dear? Bed is so lonely without you.
Lenore. I told her we were meant to be, and she became hysterical. She hasn't left me alone for 6 months.
Seems so simple when you put it that way. It must have been more than that.
Well, human emotions make it seem like so much more. Besides, I would have taken you home last night if you weren't here.
You were listening, weren't you?
You have to be a deaf man not to hear that, right? Too bad. But those are all the things that make me love you.
What?
And really, such a pity that a pretty girl such as yourself would never want to date a woman.
I never said that.
Prove it.
Oh, Eddie, I'm so sorry. You should have never said that.
Nothing at all.
bother you? May I ask you a question?
Oh, don't mind me at all. Just here, mending my broken heart.
Never mind that. I was wondering if you'd seen a girl by the name of Lenore.
Of course I've seen her. How could you miss her?
So you have seen her. Can you tell me where she may be?
Oh, she has two men gawking at her.
Ma'am, I'm afraid you're speaking in riddles. I must go get her. She hasn't been home all day and we're supposed to be married by sunset tomorrow.
Married?
Ah, yes. The most beautiful wedding in the town. We ride atop a silver horse, hand in hand.
Hand in hand?
Yes. So you see, this is crucial that she has returned to me. Can you tell me where she may be?
Oh, the wedding sounds brilliant. It's just... Oh, it's too much to bear.
What? What happened?
Oh, it's terrible. A man came and took her away. Yes, it was terrible. He kissed her senseless, and now he's having the time of his life.
He wouldn't.
And I saw her. She was terrified, terrified, senseless.
Tell me where this fiend is. I promise you will not make it out of this night alive.
Oh, well, I don't think you would be right to murder him.
I must have to. If he has the audacity to steal my maid every night, he thinks he can just steal her from me like that? Like a thief? I will protect you, Lenore!
Why you must hurt me! No, please, stop! Oh, no, sir, please! Don't hurt him, please!
You are crazy, Lenore. Elude. Did you think you could run from your destiny so easily? You are mine, Lenore. Mine forevermore.
Lenore!
Oh, Andrew! No, stop! You're going to kill him!
I don't care, Lenore. I don't care!
Police found her the next day, swinging upon a branch with a noose around her neck. Oftentimes at night, I hear her tapping upon my window, see her out in the chair, with the book in her hand. I wonder what it would have been like if I never met her at all. Would I lay restless at night, waiting for her to descend from the heavens? Each night, I have the same old dreams! One of a tapping in the Book of Lore, and a raven upon my master palace. Each night, a few more heartbroken than the last. It may have been the greatest sin fall for an engaged, innocent lady. Perhaps it is Tempest's way of torturing a broken soul. Each night he reminds me of my past, my long-lost love, Lenore, the radiant maiden whom the angels named Lenore, who lives in the heavens forevermore.